Hello class 9, I have explained to input the different data types in BlueJay. Today I will explain the data type in BlueJay by the using of scanner class. As we know that first we will write the programs in our notebook, so first we will write that program in our notebook, then I will show you how to compile that program and how to come the result on BlueJay.
I am explaining the programs based on if statement. These programs based on the if statement. Write a class with the name employee means when we will make our program that time we will give the name of that class employee, because employee name are mentioned in this. And basic as its data members, find the gross pay to an employee for the following allowances and deductions. Allowances are this: DNS allowances, DA, house rent allowances, HRA, and this is a deduction, PEF, provident fund. And then net pay, basic pay, DNS allowances plus house rent allowances. Then gross pay is equal to net pay minus provident fund. So first we will write the statements which we will find in this program, a program to calculate employees gross and net pay by using scanner class. Now first line in each and every program we will write import Java. When we are making program by using scanner class, then we will write this line import Java util dot asterisk terminator public class, then we will give the name of the class employee. Name of the class is mentioned in the question, so that we will take that name only, employee pay. Then curly bracket start, public static void main string args. This line used to input the arguments. Then curly bracket start, scanner in new scanner system dot in. This line help to the scanner classes to execute the program error free. For this program, first we will want the basic pay, so that we will take basic pay in int, because we are taking basic pay like 55 lakh, 1 lakh, 50,000, 25,000, so that the data type of basic is int, integer, because this is without decimal value. Employee name, this is EMP, employee, N for name. Employee name, this is alphabetical, and this is the set of characters, so that it is a string, so that this data type is string. Now double, DA, DNS allowances, HRA, house rent allowances, PF, provident fund, GP, gross pay, NP, net pay. We don't know what is the gross pay, so that we will take it zero. We don't know about the net pay, so that we will take it also zero. We are taking this data type double, because in this we will divide by these 100 for DNS allowances, 100 for house rent allowances, and 100 for provident fund, so that we will take these data type double, because this value will be come in decimals, so that we will take it in double. Now first we will enter the name of the employee and basic pay of that, so that system out println enter the name and basic pay of an employee. Suppose employee is the string, so that empn is equal to in dot next line. This is the data type of string. Then basic is it in int form, so that it will is basic is equal to in dot next int curly, then terminator. Now curly bracket start. Now we will put the formulas which are given in the program. First we will find DNS allowance, DA is equal to basic multiply 25 upon 100. Then an HRA, basic multiply 15.0 upon 100. PF is equal to basic multiply 8.33 upon 100. All are given in the questions. Now PF NP is equal to basic salary plus DMS allowances plus HRA house rent allowances. And gross pay is equal to when this net pay will come after adding these three, then we will minus the provident fund from that NP net pay. Now we will print the employee name, basic pay, net pay and gross pay. For this we will write system out println. This is used for printing the this line. System out println is also used to enter the data, and it is also used to display the data. So that system out println, the message is name of the employee, so that we will write in, it is in double quotes, plus EMPN, because in EMPN we have stored the name of the employee. System out println basic pay plus basic, because basic pay is stored in the basic. System out println net pay plus NP. System out println gross pay plus GP. Now we have opened two times, one and one. These two times bracket we have opened here. Three times we have opened, but one time we have closed here. This block we have closed here. Now this and this we will close in the end of the program. So that we will close this bracket two times, curly bracket two times. Now this is the example. Suppose employee name is Rakesh Kumar, basic pay 50,000. When we will take out the DA, then DA will be 12,500 and HRA 7,500, PF 4,165. Then we will take the net pay. Net pay 50,000 basic, then 12,500 plus 7,500. We will not add this value because this is wrong. We will not add this value so that now we will make that program in BlueJ. For this, first we will open that. This program I have made earlier, open editor. There we have written the coding which we have written in my video also. That coding we will write here. After completing this program, then we will do class, save, compile. Class compile, no syntax error is here. If any error is here, then it will display here. So that no error is here. Now close this. Then go employee, void main strings. Okay. First we will type the name, basic pay and name of the employee. First we will write name. Suppose I am writing Akash, A-K-A-S-H, Akash Kumar. This is the employee name, and salary is 75,000. If I am writing 75,000, enter. Now name of the employee is Akash Kumar, basic pay 75,000, net pay 10,000, net pay 1,505,000, and gross pay after deduct the PF, then it will become 98,752. Then clear this. After that, next program, income tax program, which we have done, we will do here also. Now one more program we will do on the if statement. This program, Mr. Sharma is a businessman. He pays annual income tax as per the given table. This is the table, and as per the Mr. Sharma pays annual income tax. So write a program in Java to compute the income tax to be paid by the him. This is the table, taxable income up to 1,60,000, no tax. greater than 1,60,000 but less than or equal to 5 lakh, then it will pay 10% of the amount exceeding 1,60,000 from that 5 lakh amount. Greater than 5 lakh and less than or equal to 8 lakh, then 25% of the exceeding 5 lakh. But we will add the 34,000 for that 5 lakh which we are exceeding. Now greater than rupees 8 lakh, so that 94,000 we will pay for 8 lakh, but after exceeding 8 lakh, 30% of the amount we will be pay. For this program, first we will write a program to calculate and display income tax. This is the message which we will find into the program. We are giving this message to understood that when anybody will see that program and he can understand easily which type of program is this. importjava.util, I told you in first program, public class. Here we will take income tax or any name we can take, because there is no class name mentioned, so that we can take any name from for this. Then curly bracket, public static void main string args, this I told you that this is input the arguments. Then curly bracket start scanner in is equal to new scanner system dot in int ti. Ti, why we are taking int ti? Ti is taxable income, and taxable income are is in integer form. This income without decimals income is there, so that it will take be int. Then double tax, because when we will find the income tax, that time we will divide that by 100, so that value will come in decimal, so that we will take it in double tax. Tax we don't know, so that we will write tax is equal to 0.0. now for this program, first we will enter the taxable income, so that enter taxable income, then we will write the data type TI is equal to in dot next int. Now curly bracket start. Now we will put the condition according to the program. First we will write up to 1,60,000, so that if taxable income less than and equal to 1,60,000, then tax is equal to 0, because tax is nil, so that tax will be 0. Next condition, if taxable income is greater than, if taxable income is greater than 1,60,000, and this is or, and taxable income is less than and equal to 5 lakh which is mentioned in the program, then tax is equal to taxable income minus 1,60,000, because 1,60,000 rupees free for income tax, so that we will minus that taxable income 1,60,000. Then after exceeding 1,60,000, then we will find the percentage of that amount, 10%. Then next condition, if taxable income is greater than 5 lakh and taxable income is less than and equal to 8 lakh, then tax is equal to taxable income minus 5 lakh, because we are exceeding 5 lakh. Multiply after exceeding 5 lakh, then we will take out that taxable income 20%. Then we will plus 34,000 for 5 lakh rupees. If taxable income is equal to 8 is greater than 8 lakh, then tax is equal to taxable income minus 8 lakh, because till 8 lakh we have paid this amount, so that after exceeding 8 lakh the remaining amount will be multiplied by 30/100. Then this is the 30% of that amount, then plus 94,000 we will plus for the 8 lakh, so that we will plus 94,000 tax for 8 lakh. Now system out println, first we will print the taxable income, that is TI, and system out println income tax is equal to plus tax. So now we will close two times bracket, because we have opened two times, we have opened three times here, but 1, 2 and 3 there, 1 I have closed here. Then after completing the program, that we will close two types of bracket. Now this is the example. Suppose the taxable income is equal to 1,60,000, then to tax is equal to 0. If the taxable income is 7 lakh, then we will find like this: 7 lakh minus 1,60,000 multiplied by 20. 7 lakh minus 60,000, not 7 lakh minus 5 lakh. Then multiply 20 upon 100 plus 34,000. Then the amount of this, because we will write 5 lakh here, not 1,60,000. We will write 5 lakh here. So that the 5 lakh tax will, the remaining amount 2 lakh tax will be 4,000 and the 34,000 for that 5 lakh. So then we will plus 40,000 plus 34,000. It will become 74,000. This is the tax of 7 lakh taxable income. So that the Mr. Sharma will pay 74 lakh if he get 7 lakh salary. Now one more program I have explained you, income tax. Same, first we will open this, open editor. This is the coding which I have written in my video. First we will write in our copy, after that we will write this coding, same coding on BlueJ screen. After writing this, then we will save this class, then compile. Class compile, no syntax error. If any error is here, it will display here, but no error is here, then close this. Now income tax, void main string, okay. In this, enter taxable income. Suppose taxable income is equal is 9 lakh. We are writing 75 lakh. Seven lakh fifty thousand. Then enter this. This is taxable income, 7,50,000. Taxable income is 7,50,000, and income tax on this income is 84,000. Today I have explained you two programs, employee pay and income tax. Next program I will explain in my upcoming video. Thank you class 9, and you will try to make this program.
First program I have explained to input the basic salary. Then we will find the DA, HRA, PF, net pay, and we will print the gross pay of an employee. And second program, we will find the income tax. Hope you all understood both the programs, and you will complete your work at time. You will not disappoint me. Thank you.